Finally, is Councillor Anita Leech, and I am the Chair of the Committee. My role this evening is to ensure that the Committee runs smoothly, having regard to procedure, behaviour and ethics. To explain who the rest of the people on the tables here tonight are, to my immediate right is the Council's Solicitor, who will give advice to the Committee on any procedural or legal matters that might arise. To my left are the Council's Planning Officers, Highways Engineer and Environmental Health Officer, who will present the applications this evening and give any technical advice to the Committee which may be sought. The rest of the people you see down both sides of the tables are the elected members who will consider the applications this evening and make the decisions. Before each application is considered, there will be a short presentation by the Planning Officer. In the event that an application has received a qualifying petition signed by 25 signatures or more, one representative of the petition will be invited to address the committee in support of the petition for up to 5 minutes. If a petitioner addresses the committee, then the applicant or their agent will be invited to make representations to the committee in support of their application, again for up to 5 minutes. However, if a petitioner has not addressed the committee, then the applicant or the agent will not be invited to make any representation. A ward councillor can address the committee in relation to an application. The ward councillor may speak on behalf of the residents. However, once the ward councillor has returned to the public gallery, they may not return to take part in any debate that may follow by the committee. The applications will then be opened to debate and discussion by members of the planning committee, who will then make a decision on the application. The order of tonight's agenda may vary subject to the number of people who are here in relation to a specific agenda item, and subject to the committee agreeing to the order being varied. If a site visit is requested and approved by the committee, that matter will not be discussed any further this evening, and anybody who's here for those applications is free to leave should they so wish. Committee, can I have approval for the minutes on page 1 to 4?
Yes, Chair.
Thank you. Thank you. Are there any declarations of interest? No? Thank you. Are there any requests for site visits? Irene? Please feel free to do so now. Okay, just to confirm that those matters will not be discussed this evening. Judging by the number of people that are here this evening for the fire station, I'd like to move that we go to agenda item 8 first, if that's the Okay, so if we move to agenda item 8, which is pages 47 to 68 in your papers, and Randy, could we have a presentation, please? Thank you.
This application was the subject of a member's site visit on Tuesday. Planning Commission is sought for the erection of a two-bay, single-storey community fire station, incorporating operational and welfare accommodation, offices and meeting space, external trade facilities and associated car parking. This is a revised application following the refusal of Planning Commission in December 2016. A number of changes have taken place since the earlier refused planning application. These are as follows. A 30% reduction in the developed site area. A 12.5% reduction in the footprint of the building, which includes a reduction in length by 7.6 metres. The building has been located further away from properties along Woodpecker Close, and the car parking has been relocated off the boundary of Woodpecker Close and adjacent to the building itself. The sprinkler and generator have been relocated to the west side of the site, away from properties on Woodpecker Close. The amount of hard sanding has been reduced, including the removal of an access road to the west side of the building. Additional landscaping will be provided around site boundaries, and the retractable tower has also been relocated onto the west side of the site. Additional changes made include the replacement of the proposed paladine fencing with a 2 metres high close-boarded timber fence along the boundary with Woodpecker Close. Changes to the aluminium cladding, to timber cladding around the entire building, and incorporating a cedar roof for the entire roof rather than just half the roof as originally proposed. The site will be partially excavated, particularly at the rear, to provide for a level site. Land levels will therefore be reduced by around 0.2 metres at the front of the site and between 2 and 3 metres at the rear of the site, meaning that the building will sit lower into the site than the site is at present and will sit lower than properties on Woodpecker Close. The site boundary with Woodpecker Close has moved some 5 metres further away, and would be 8 metres further away from the side elevation with 281 Silverbassy Road. The nearest part of the building would be located 35 metres away from 68 Woodpecker Close, which is an increase of some 5 metres from the previous application, and 40 metres away from the gable elevation of 281 Silverbassy Lane, and this is an increase of some 10 metres from that previously proposed. The reduction in the length of the building by some 7.6 metres means that the building will also be further away from numbers 70 and 72 Woodpecker Close, particularly when taking into account the repositioning of the building within the site. The buildings would be located between, would be located between 56 and 65 metres away from the front elevations of the properties on Cllr Road, opposite the site. The buildings have been reorientated within the site to avoid directly looking onto those properties. The repositioned sprinkler and generator to the west of the site means this element of the proposal is now 66 metres away from the nearest residential property. The recited training tower would be 70 metres away from the nearest residential property. The training tower is retractable. Therefore, when not in use, the height would be 4 metres, which is lower than the main building, where the eaves height is 5 metres with a ridge height of 8. When fully extended, the height would be 13 metres. tap would only be open when training takes place, and there are conditions proposed to ensure the tower is down and collapsed when not in use. There are no specific details available on how long it would take for the structure to go up or down, but clearly from an operational and practical perspective, the fire service would require this to be as quickly as possible. As set out in the report, this proposal constitutes inappropriate development in the green belt. As such, very special circumstances are required to outweigh any harm to the openness of the green belt. The proposal is located on the edge of the primarily residential area and has come forward as a result of budget reductions which have led to rationalisation of stations, resulting in some closures and the merging of others within new stations located in strategically efficient locations. The Merseyside Fire and Rescue Service have approved the closure of Upton and West Kirby Fire Stations and have put forward a case of a new centrally located fit-for-purpose station within the coverage area to provide the best possible cover within the best achievable response times. There is clear evidence that demonstrates that the level of damage, severity of injury, and likelihood of death decreases with more rapid response times. Therefore, the quicker the fire service responds to the incident, the likelihood of survivability increases. The very special circumstances that need to provide the best achievable emergency response to the entire combined coverage area of Upton and West Kirby stations, which has a population of some 85,000. Increased response times are likely to contribute to increased fatality rates or serious injury and or damaged property being decreased. There is no national response standard, and in 2013, following public consultation and as a direct result of cuts to the fire service budget, a 10-minute response time was introduced. However, the fire service aspired to respond to emergencies much more quickly.